Testing your prototypes is one of the final steps in design thinking. I developed a prototype of a professional development session for teachers on helping them to understand how technology can extend student learning. To test my prototype, I came up with the following protocol. I created a slide presentation of what would be presented in the professional development session. I then sent this presentation via email to four middle school teachers. I asked the following questions of, what is your first thought or feeling after viewing the presentation? What stood out to you? What part did you not understand, if any? What part made the most sense? Did this presentation give you at least one takeaway of something you could do in the classroom? And what was this takeaway? I asked these questions in order to get their thoughts and feelings, understand what didn't work and what needed to change in the presentation, and also to understand what was working and what could even be improved on more. It can be hard to get honest feedback from a colleague in a face-to-face situation, which is why I chose to deliver this presentation electronically so I could get the most honest and correct feedback as possible. As teachers made their way through this presentation, I presented different ideas through video, words, and other objects. At the end, I asked them to email me back their feedback. Their feedback showed me a few things. Number one, my testing process is not done. In fact, I need to go back, make some tweaks to this presentation, and continue testing. I also learned that even though my presentation did have good takeaways, there were also some things that I could change, including the fact that I could even make this into two presentations if I desired to do so. This testing process is not done. Even once I create the final product, I know that as I present this information, things are going to change based on my users and my audience, and I need to be willing to keep testing and testing.